In this video, we are going to demonstrate how to set up payables options and create vendors in Drake Accounting. Select the client from the Client Selector screen and navigate to Payables Options. On the General Options tab, you can choose to automatically generate accounting transactions. Select to which journal you would like vendor payments recorded. Next, if you plan on producing invoices for your client, you have the ability to autofill invoice descriptions with the vendor code, vendor name, or client account. These flow to the journal and create the descriptions for journal transactions. In the 1099 Miscellaneous Options section, specify where non-defaulted payments should map to on the 1099 Miscellaneous. If you select Vendor Default, then payments flow to whatever 1099 Miscellaneous field is designated under Vendor Setup. To specify a 1099 Miscellaneous field for all of this client's vendor payments, select it from the Other drop list. Please note that this can be overridden on a per-vendor basis under Vendor Setup. If desired, set a default due date under Invoice Options for all newly created invoices. At the bottom of the screen, you can choose to suppress check stub printing for direct deposit, suppress display of terminated vendors, and/or suppress $0 1099 amounts on check stub. We chose to automatically generate transactions, so we need to complete the GL Account Numbers tab. All accounts selected here are the default accounts for all vendors and can be overridden on an individual vendor basis. Select the cash account number to be used when paying vendors. If required, assign accounts from the Withholding Account Number drop list. Assign the default expense account for non-1099 vendors from the non-1099 expense account drop list. In the bottom portion of the tab, designate expense accounts for corresponding 1099 Miscellaneous fields. Click Save. Under the Payables module, select Vendor Setup to add a new vendor. Click New. Enter an easily recognizable vendor code and a company name, first name, and last name. Complete the rest of the vendor's personal information. In the 1099 Options section, you can either mark Do Not Generate a 1099 for this vendor, or use the default drop list to designate where payments will map to on the 1099. To associate a division with this vendor, select it from the drop list. Use the Start Date field to enter the initial service date for the vendor. From the status drop list, choose either active or terminated. Enter the client account number if the vendor has one assigned to the client. The withholding tab is only active for 1099 vendors. Drake Accounting can calculate federal and/or calculate state withholdings for this vendor. Select the checkbox to activate the withholding, then set the amount as either dollar cents or percent. Review the GL account numbers tab. Accounts that have been set up under options as defaults are shown in light blue to the right of the field. To override an account, simply select a new one from the drop list. To set up direct deposit for this vendor, you must first establish an account with CodaPay. See the direct deposit overview video if you need assistance. Select direct deposit checks. Choose the account type. If you choose checkings and savings, enter an amount either in dollars and cents or a percentage to be applied to the savings account. The remainder of the vendor's check will be deposited into the checking account. Enter the vendor's bank routing and account numbers. If the checking and savings account have the same routing number, select Use Same Routing Number. Use the Notes tab to enter any miscellaneous information you wish to about the vendor. After you enter the note about the vendor, check the Append Date, Time, On Startup box in the lower left-hand corner of the screen to timestamp the note for future reference. Click Save. For more information, visit accounting.drakesoftware.com.